maybe forgotten about that. But we give God thanks for those of you who remember and has joined this morning in worship. Bless the name of the Lord. The Lord is good. Hallelujah. And we give him thanks. We give him praise. We lift him up this morning. Hallelujah. Because indeed he is worthy. Hallelujah. This morning I just want to speak to you on a simple topic. And you may have based on the scripture that was read, the songs that were played, you may have already drawn conclusion from that. But this morning I want to speak to you on the topic. There is power in the name of Jesus. How many of you believe that this morning? That there is power in the name of Jesus. Bless the name of the Lord. And the scripture reading will be taken from Philippians 2, verse 9 through 11. Philippians 2, verse 9 through 11. There is power in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for today. We thank you for your love. We thank you, God, for your mercies. We thank you, Lord God, that Father, that there is no name above yours this morning. Father, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you praise. Father, as we're about to go into the word, I pray this morning, Lord God, that Father, that you, Father, will speak through me. I pray, Lord God, that every word of my mouth and every meditation of my heart will be acceptable to you this morning. I pray, Father God, that Father, that those who are listening in today, Lord God, I pray, Lord God, that you'll set their mind, their heart on you, Lord God. I pray, oh God, that they'll be focused on you, Lord God, and as your word go forth, Lord God, that they will get, Lord God, to help them throughout their daily life, Lord. Father, I pray that you'll just have your way today, Lord God. Father, lead and direct, Lord God. I pray, oh God, that Father God, that you'll touch those who need to be touched this morning. I pray, oh God, that you'll strengthen, Father, those who need to be strengthened. I pray, oh God, that Father, that you'll deliver those who need to be delivered, Father God, through your word, Lord God. Have your way, Lord. As we look to you, we say thanks in your mighty and your holy name, I pray. Amen. And amen. There is power in the name of Jesus. I won't be before you for very long, but my prayer today is that as the message goes forth, that you will gather something from it. Philippians 2, verse 9 through 11, it reads, therefore God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue acknowledging that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. Bless the name of the Lord. You know, when we speak about the name of a person, we're basically addressing their identity. If I should ask Carlene to put something in the chat this morning, Brianna would not do so because Carlene is not her name or her identity. Andrea would not put something because again, Carlene is not her name or her identity. Names are far more than a mere term or a mere nomenclature. It's a way to distinguish one person identification. Names really mattered. If we should go back and look in the Bible, names really matter in the Bible because a person was given a name that often reflect the parents' hopes and dreams for the child or identified what that child was destined to become. In Bible times, names were important. They carry a meaning unlike modern day names. In many modern cultures, a name is often used as a personal label. In Bible times, however, a great significance was attached to a person's name. The name was often determined by some circumstance at the time of birth. And take, for example, in Genesis chapter 25, verse 25 and 26, the Bible said, and the first came out red, all over like an hairy garment, and they call his name Esau. In Genesis 35 and verse 18, it reads, and it came to pass as her soul was in departing, before she died, that she called his name Benoni, but his father called him Benjamin. So you see, the name was given because of the circumstance at the time of birth. In 1 Chronicles chapter 4 and verse 9, the Bible said, and Jabez was more honorable than his brothers, and his mother called his name Jabez, saying, because I bore him with sorrow. The name was given that was often the name given was often determined by some circumstances at the time of birth. Genesis 19 said, but hurry, escape to it, for I can do nothing until you arrive there. And this explains why that village was known as Zoar, which means little place. Sometimes the name given express a hope or a prophecy. For example, in Isaiah 8, verse 1 through 4, the Lord said to me, he reads, the Lord said to me, take a large scroll and write on it with an ordinary pen, Mahershalal Hashbaz. The Bible said, so I called in Uriah the priest and Zechariah, a son of Zeberechiah, as reliable witness for me. Then I made love to the prophetess, and she conceived and gave birth to a son. And the Lord said to me, name him Mahershalalashbaz, for before the boy knows how to say my father or my mother, the wealth of Damascus will be carried off by the king of Assyria. The name sometimes expresses a hope. Or a prophecy. In this case, it expressed a prophecy. If you look further in the Bible, you'll notice that various people's name were changed. The Lord changed the name of Abram to Abraham in view of his destiny. Genesis 17, verse 5 says, neither shall thy name anymore be called Abram, but thy name shall be Abraham, for a father of many nations have I made thee. The name Abraham meant father of a great multitude. Sarai was changed to Sarah. Yes, I know both names mean princess, but God was looking at the destiny of Sarah. She was to become the mother of many nations. Jacob. His name was changed to Israel because he demonstrated that he was willing to let God prevail in his life. And in response, God changed Jacob's name to Israel, meaning let God prevail. And that God promised Israel that all the blessings that had been pronounced upon Abraham's head would also be his. Simon, he was called Peter. Saul became Paul. Their names reflected their destinies in God's plan. And so names matter to God. Names matter to our King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And as mentioned earlier, or with a more significant name than his only begotten son, Jesus Christ. Jesus is the name that is above every name. And as Paul wrote in Philippians 2, verse 9 through 11, he said, therefore God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. There is no name above the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Not Buddha, not Haile Selassie, not Hare Krishna. No name, hallelujah, is above the name of Jesus Christ. His name trumps all other name. At the name of Jesus, every knee, every knee, every knee must bow. Every tongue must confess. Bless the name of the Lord. Whether you're in heaven, you're on earth, you're under the earth, bless the name of the Lord. Every, the Bible said, every knee must bow. Every tongue acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord. Hallelujah. Give him praise this morning. Hallelujah. He deserves our worship today. Hallelujah. So when hallelujah, bless the name of the Lord. It requires faith to believe in the power of Jesus' name. Without faith, his name will not be powerful, but with faith, the name of Jesus is the most powerful name there is. You couple the name of Jesus with faith, it's the most powerful there is. We are instructed in the Bible to pray in the name of Jesus and with authority. John 16, verse 23 through 24. In John 14, verse 14, Jesus said, if you ask me anything in my name, he said, I will do it. If you ask me anything, hallelujah, in my name, I will do it. When we, let me tell you this morning, friends, you know, when we invoke the name of Jesus, we're not just uttering a word. When we call on the name of Jesus, we are not just, it's not just lip service. We are not just uttering a word. We are calling upon the power and the authority of the creator of the universe. Hallelujah. And this is the power that is unmatched. It's unparalleled. It's a power that can move mountain, a power that can calm storms, a power that can break chains, hallelujah, a power that can set the captive free, a power that can deliver this morning, hallelujah. You're not just uttering a name this morning when you call on the name of Jesus, but you're calling on the power, hallelujah, the power of the creator of heaven and earth. There's no name like the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. No name like the name of Jesus. His name has power. His name carries authority. Hallelujah. When you call on his great name, things change. Circumstances change. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. By faith, the disciples, they perform miracles, signs, and wonders in the name of Jesus. Luke 10 and verse 17. If you check Acts 4, verse 29 through 30. This morning, I just want to let you know, we have the same power that Jesus has. He has given us the Holy Spirit. We have the Holy Spirit within us. And so when we place our faith in him as Lord and Savior, we can do mighty exploits for him. We can do mighty. In heaven and earth is found in the wonderful name of Jesus, and he has given it to us. He has given it to us. How many of you really get this morning? He has given it to us. We have been given the name to use at our disposal. That means whatever we need, hallelujah, whatever need we have, we have been given a name that everyone and everything has to listen to and obey at the mention of that name. We have the right to use that name against our enemies. We have the right to use that name in our petitions. We have the right to use the name in our praise and worship. That name has been given to us. Heaven and earth and hell recognize what Jesus did, and all that Jesus did, all the authority, all the power, all the achievements are in his name. Hallelujah. In his name. And if we keep his name on our lips, keep it in our heart, it will work the same now as it did back then. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. We have the right to use the name in our petition. We have the right to use the name against our enemies. Hallelujah. We have the right to use the name in our worship, in our praises. Hallelujah. He has given us. The name Jesus, it defines our Lord's role as Savior who deliver us from our sins and our enemies. In Matthew chapter 1 and verse 21, it says, she will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. Hallelujah. Bless the name of God. A lot of people want to use the name and the power of Jesus to rescue them from everything that they face, but their sins. They want to use the name of Jesus to rescue them from everything but their sin. They don't want to do his will, but they want to reap the benefit. When sickness comes, when the tough times comes, when they are faced with our problems on every side, they want to call on his name for rescue. But yet they still want to hang on to their sinful ways. They don't want to let that go. But they want to call on Jesus for help. But I like the way it was Dr. Tony Evans. I like the way he put it. He said, asking God to address other issues in our life without addressing sin is like having cancer and asking the doctor to give you aspirin for the pain without treating the disease. Let me say that again. It's a quote from Dr. Tony Evans. Said, asking God to address other issues in our lives without addressing sin is like having cancer and asking the doctor to give you aspirin for the pain without treating the disease. Jesus wants to deal with sin because everything, whether it's negative in our lives, is related directly or incorrectly to the presence of sin. When you call on the name of Jesus, you are asking him not only to deal with the root of your problem, but the root of the problem. He can fix the root of the problem this morning, and that's what he came to do. Let me tell you, the greatest power in the name of Jesus is the power of salvation from sin. The greatest power in the name of Jesus is the power of salvation from sin. It is only through his name that salvation comes.
comes through no other. Only through the name of Jesus. Chapter 1:21 said, and she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sin. Acts 4 and verse 12. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. John 3:18, he said, the Bible said, he that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. You cannot be forgiven of your sins in any other way but only through the name of Jesus. You cannot gain access to God except through Jesus. I'll say that again. You cannot gain access to God except through Jesus. In John 14 and verse 6, Jesus said unto him, I am the way. He said, I am the truth and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. That's the word of God. You cannot gain access to God except through Jesus. Salvation comes only through the name of Jesus. Confession of the name of Jesus is important to salvation. Hallelujah. Romans 10 and verse 9 to 10, it said, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and shalt believe in thine heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. The power to become a child of God is he became what we were, that we might become what he did. Corinthians, 2 Corinthians 5, verse 21, he said, for he hath made him to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. That does not mean that Jesus became a sinner. No, he did not. He became sin. He took upon in himself. He took our place as our substitute when our sin was laid on him. There is power in the name of Jesus. And though your sin this morning, though they may be as scarlet, they can be as white as snow. He can wash you clean today, because there is still power in the name of Jesus. So no matter what you are out, well, where you have been, no matter what you have been through, he can clean you up today. Doesn't matter what you have done. It doesn't matter where you have been. He has the power to make you new. He has the power to make you whole. Just confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead. The Bible says, and you shall. Hallelujah, that's the word this morning. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There's no name above his name. His name trumps all other names. Hallelujah, at the name of Jesus, the Bible said, every knee, hallelujah, must bow, and every tongue, they must confess Jesus Christ, that he is Lord. He is Lord. Lord over you, Lord over me this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. If you should call. The story, you see, I think it's Mark chapter 5. You remember she had suffered much at the hands of many doctors and had spent all she had. She spent all she had, but instead of getting better, she grew worse. Her condition worsened. But when she heard about Jesus, hallelujah, when she heard about the man who stilled the storm, when she heard about the miracle worker, hallelujah, when she heard about the great deliverer, when she heard about Jesus, she came up behind him in the crowd and she touched the hem of his garment, thinking, if I just touch his clothes, I will be healed. The Bible said immediately. Immediately her bleeding stopped and she was free from her suffering. It was the power of Jesus' name that brought healing to this woman, and it's the same power that can bring healing to you today. Same power. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Hallelujah. He never changed. The same power that he had then. Hallelujah. The same power that's available to us today. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in his name. Hallelujah. There is power. The power of Jesus' name is also, it's evident in the victory. It ensures in the spiritual battles we face the name of Jesus. Let me tell you, it's our greatest weapon. The Apostle Paul writes in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10 through 11, he said, finally, he said, be strong in the Lord, the full armor of God, so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. One, let me tell you, one of the key components of this armor is the sword of the Spirit, which is a word of God, Ephesians 6:17. When we wield the name of Jesus in our spiritual battle, we are wielding the very power of God himself. And this is the power that can overcome any enemy. It can break any stronghold. Any chains, he can break it and it can secure victory. Hallelujah. When we pray in the name of Jesus, hallelujah, we are partnering with God to bring about his kingdom on earth. Jesus taught his disciples to pray, he said, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So as we pray in the name of Jesus, we are aligning ourselves with God's purposes and releasing his power into the world. Yes. So as we pray in the name of Jesus, we are aligning ourselves with God's purpose and releasing his power into the world. And this is a power that can transform societies. It can heal, bring about justice and righteousness. There is power in the name of Jesus. At the name of Jesus, every knee will bow, every tongue must confess. Hallelujah. There's no name above the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. His name has power and authority. Hallelujah. And no matter what you're going through, no matter what your circumstance is, hallelujah, when you call on his name, things must change. Must change. Hallelujah. That's the name of the Lord. The power of the name of Jesus is not just for our benefit. It is for the glory of God. As we read in Philippians 2:11, said, and every tongue acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. When we experience the power of Jesus' name in our lives, it is not so that we can boast in our own strength or accomplishments. It is so that we can give glory to the one who has given us this power. Our testimonies of healing, victory, and transformation are meant to point others to the greatness of our God and the power of his name. So finally, it is important to recognize that the power of the name of Jesus is not something we can access through our own efforts or our merits. Jesus himself said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. He said, no one comes to the Father except through me. It is only through faith in Jesus and the power of his name that we can experience the fullness of God's power in our lives. Only through Jesus that we can experience the fullness of God's power. Hallelujah. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is still power in his name. Hallelujah. Demons have to flee when we call on the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Sickness has to go when we call on the name of Jesus. If you want deliverance, hallelujah, call on his name, hallelujah. His name has power. There is power in his name. So as believers, hallelujah, we are fully convinced of the power within the name. When we pray, we have the power of Jesus at work within us. Our lives as Christian are lived from a place of acknowledging the power in Jesus' name. And whatever you do, Colossians said, whatever you do in word or deed, he said, do in the name of the Lord Jesus. Do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The powerful name of Jesus makes it possible for all people to be saved. Hallelujah. I said the powerful name of Jesus makes it possible for all people to be saved. Hallelujah. For all people to be healed, for people to be delivered. Psalm 115 reminds us, not to us, O Lord, not to us, but to your name, give glory for the sake of your steadfast love and your faithfulness. There is power in the name of Jesus. His name trumps all other names. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you want to be saved, you have to go through Jesus. You have to call on the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. His name still has power. Power to save. Power to heal. Power to deliver. Hallelujah. Power to set free this morning. There is power in the name of Jesus. No matter how bound you may be this morning, no matter how the enemy have you tied up this morning, if you call on his name, if you call on his great name this morning, hallelujah, he can break those chains, those shackles that the enemy have on you this morning. If you call on his name, he can break them. Hallelujah. There is power in the name of Jesus. There's power in his great name. There's power in his name. No matter what you are going through, no matter what you are faced with this morning, he's still in the same. In the business, bless the name of the Lord. Call on him this morning. Call on him. Exercise your faith. Hallelujah. Your faith coupled with the name of Jesus. Bless the name of the Lord. Means that you can do great things. Hallelujah. Call on him this morning. He is here for you, for those of you who are not saved this morning. He can turn your life around. He can change your circumstances. There is still power in the name of Jesus. There is still power in his name. Call on him this morning. Though your sins, though they may be as scarlet, he can make them. He can make you them as white as snow. He can clean you up this morning. He can wash you this morning. He will make you whole. Anything you ask in his name, as long as you're under his will, as long as you subscribe to his will, as long as you do what he tells you to do, as long as you're obedient to him this morning, he will turn your situation around. Hallelujah. He can turn it around for you this morning. There is still power in the name of Jesus. There is still power in his name. Will you this morning, if you're not saved, will you give him a chance in your life? Will you try Jesus this morning? Like the lady with the woman with the issue of blood, she tried everything. The doctors couldn't help. But when she heard about Jesus, when she called on Jesus, when she pressed through that crowd and she touched the hem of his garment, she was made whole. You can be made whole this morning. If you reach out and touch him. Touching Jesus is all that matters this morning. I can assure you that when you touch him, your life will never be the same. Hallelujah. Just reach out. Call on him this morning. for those of you who are saved. Call on him no matter what you're going through. Yes, you might be you're faced with some tough times, and sometimes it might seem as if, yes, I've called, I've been praying, I've been calling on his name, but it seems as if nothing is happening. Don't stop. Hallelujah, don't stop. Like the woman again with the issue of blood, she pressed her way through. Keep pressing this morning. Keep pushing. Keep calling on his name. Hallelujah. He will come through for you. Remember God's timing. It's not our timing. So don't give up. Don't give in. Don't throw in the towel. Trust him. Lean on him. Call on his great name. Call him this morning, and he will do it for you. He'll change your circumstances. He'll turn it around this morning. Hallelujah. He will change it for you today. Let us pray. Hallelujah. Father, how majestic is your name in all the earth. Your word says that at the name of Jesus, every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord over everything. You said that if we ask for anything in your name, you will do it. And so, Father, we know that we cannot ask in your name unless we ask it according to your will and your way. And so we come to you today, Father. We come to you, Lord God, Father, because we need you now more than ever. Father, this morning I place before you, Father, your children, Father, those who, Father, they're not saved, Lord God, but they need you, Lord God. They need a Savior this morning. And Father God, that's what you came when you came to earth. You came, Lord God, Father God, and you, Lord God, you took on our sins, Lord God, so that we, Lord God, can be forgiven, so that, Father, we can be reconciled unto the Father this morning. And so, Father God, this morning I pray, Lord God, for those, Lord God, who are in sin, Lord God. Father God, I pray for those who are not saved this morning. I pray, oh God, that Father God, as you touch their heart, Lord God, as Father God, I pray this morning, Lord God, that as you reach down and as you touch them, Lord God, I pray, oh God, that they, Lord God, will just reach out, Lord God, and touch you, Lord God, like that woman with the issue of blood. I pray this morning, Lord God, that you will help them, Lord God, our Father, to say, Lord God, that I believe, Lord God, I believe that you came. I believe that you died and you rose, our Father God, so that I can be saved, Lord God. I pray this morning that you forgive them of their sins. I pray, oh God, that you will cleanse them. I pray that you will wash them. I pray, oh God, that you will make them whole, Lord God. I pray this morning, Lord God, that Father God, that when that they'll cry out, I yield this morning, Lord God. And Father God, when you wash them, Lord God, Father God, when you cleanse them, I pray, oh God, that you'll help them not to go back to that sinful state, Lord God. But Father God, that they'll press forward in you, Lord God, knowing that you, Lord God, Father God, is their King, Lord God, that you can raise them up, that you, Lord God, can strengthen them, Lord God, that you can make them whole this morning. Touch your people, Lord God. For those who are saved and is going through tough times, to rough times, Lord God, I pray, oh God, that you help them, Lord God, to continue to call on your great name, because there is still power in the name of Jesus. There is still power in your name, Lord God. Your word said at the name of Jesus that every knee will bow, shall bow, and every tongue they must confess, Lord God. And so this morning, Father God, you said that, Father God, that we should ask anything, we ask for anything in your name, Lord God, that you will do it. And so, Father God,
I pray this morning for those, Lord God, who are saved, Lord God, who are calling on you, Lord God. Maybe, Father God, they are sick, Lord God, and they need a healing. I pray this morning that you will bring forth healing in their bodies. I pray, Lord God, that every cell, our Father, that you have created, Lord God, in their body, I pray, oh God, that it will be aligned the way that you created it, Lord God. I pray this morning that, Father God, that you will bring healing, our Father, where healing is needed, because there is still power in your name. As they call on your name, I pray, oh God, that you'll bring deliverance. I pray this morning that you'll bring peace where peace is needed. I pray that you will bring, they will feel that joy, from you, Lord God, as you wrap your arms around people, Lord. Have your way this morning. Have your way this morning. Touch your people, Father God, and these platforms, Lord God, Facebook, Meta, Zoom, Father, wherever they are at, Father, listening in this morning, I pray, oh God, that, Father God, that you just reach down and just touch them, Lord God. Remind them, Lord God, that there's power in your great name. And when they call on you, things will change, Lord God. Chains will be broken, our Father God. People will be set free. Hallelujah. Help them to continue to call on you, Lord God. Set their minds, their hearts at the place, Lord God. Our Father God, where everything that they do is done in your great name. Father, we lift you up, we magnify you, we glorify you this morning. Have your way in our lives. Have your way in our church. Have your way, Lord God. Have your way. We give you honor, glory, and praise. As we look to you, we say thanks. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. I pray this morning that you were blessed by the word this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I just want to encourage you to just continue to call on the name of Jesus. There is still power in his name. There is power in the name of Jesus. Call on him. Hallelujah. Irrespective of what you face. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter how tied up in sin you may think you are. Hallelujah. His name, hallelujah, has power this morning. Power to save. Power to deliver. Power to set free. Call on him. Hallelujah. God bless you all this morning. Facebook, hallelujah. God bless you all. Those of you on Zoom, God bless you. Keep trusting God. Keep calling on him. Hallelujah. And watch him work things out in your life. Bless you.